Almost all of us have struggled with our cars being stuck in a muddy puddle. We know that cars and water don't go together. A lot can go wrong. But let's picture this. You're driving by the beach and taking the sunset in when you decide that you want to drive into the water. And absolutely nothing goes wrong. Sounds crazy. With amphibious vehicles, it's not. Amphibious vehicles can run on both land and water. As intriguing as it sounds, they've been in production for quite some time now. The first amphibious vehicle, in fact, was built in 1805. Oliver Evans was a U.S.-based inventor who built the Oructor Amphibolos, the first self-propelled amphibious vehicle. He powered it with a steam engine. Since then, these amphibious vehicles have continued to evolve all through the 20th century. This happened largely during the Second World War, which paved the way for a high demand of military amphibious vehicles. Since then, these vehicles have come a long way. So, without further ado, here are 15 incredible amphibious vehicles that you need to see and know about. 1. Water Car Panther. With the classic Jeep look, the Water Car Panther can do an impressive 45 miles per hour in the water and 80 miles per hour on land. Dave March, the founder of Panther, also designed it. Starting production in 2013, it is based on a Jeep CJ8 Scrambler. It consists of 3.7-liter Honda V6 engine for driving on land, along with a water jet engine for driving in water. The Panther is made up of high-tech materials. It has also received a Guinness World Record for the fastest amphibious vehicle on sale. Water Car has described Panther as virtually unsinkable. The statement comes from the fact that the car has over 900 liters of styrofoam in the hull. Needless to say, it is also approved by the U.S. Coast Guard. The Panther's base price is $158,000. However, the price can increase with specific options. 2. Sea Lion. Sea Lion is a car that goes fast and looks unique. It goes fast on land as well as in water. The car has a top speed of 201 kilometers per hour on land and 96 kilometers per hour in water. It is one of the most all-terrain cars in the world and is the world's fastest amphibious land speed vehicle. The Sea Lion was designed by Mark Witt. It was made using TIG welded 5052 aluminum and was CNC milled. 3. Gibbs Quad Ski. The Gibbs Quad Ski combines the best of an ATV and jet ski. Producing 140 horsepower, it has got a speed of 45 miles per hour both on land and in water. It can be used in water for up to 2 hours. Its transition between land and water is super swift. It takes less than 5 seconds for it to retract its wheels and its proprietary jet propulsion system to take over. This can be done by just pushing a button. The amphibious car uses BMW's Motorrad's 1.3-liter engine for land. It's a one-seater, and it's available in the U.S. for about $40,000. 4. Cami Hydra Spider. The Hydra Spider is an open-top, four-seater, and high-performance amphibious car. It has been speed-tested on land to 125 miles per hour and up to 53 miles per hour in water. It's powered by a jet impeller and a Corvette LS2 6-liter V8 engine. Built by Cool Amphibious Manufacturers International, the Hydra Spider is one of the most expensive amphibious cars. Not to mention, it is absolutely stunning. It has got looks that combine a sport boat with a sports car. It comes equipped with a 5-speed manual close ratio transmission. As intriguing as all that sounds, we'll say it again. It is one of the most expensive amphibians. The Hydra Spider costs about $275,000. 5. Gibbs Humdinger. The Gibbs Humdinger has got quite a unique look. Rather than looking like a can that can float, it looks more like a boat with wheels. However, despite its peculiar looks, the Humdinger is a tough utility vehicle both on land and in water. Also, the manufacturer of the quad ski, Gibbs, refers to the Humdinger as its amphi truck. Like other Gibbs amphibious vehicles, the truck's transmission time from land to water is under 5 seconds. It can also ride over its bow wave in under 10 seconds. With 9 seats, the Gibbs Humdinger has got a Mercury Marine 4.3-liter V8 engine. It can go up to 80 miles per hour on land and up to 30 miles per hour in water. 6. Rinspeed Splash. Rinspeed, the Swiss brand, manufactured the Splash in 2004. It can go with speed up to 50 kilometers per hour in water by flying on its water wings and 200 kilometers per hour on land. It is one of the most unique amphibious cars that there are. Rinspeed is known for its unique and almost crazy concept cars, so Splash is not different either. Instead of using a boat hull, Splash's spoiler swings around to act as a hydrofoil, which is a technology used in high-speed boats. Hence, the car glides over water. Powered by a 750cc two-cylinder turbocharged engine and an efficient 140 horsepower motor, the Splash is designed to run on clean-burning natural gas instead of petrol. Even though the power output is as low as 140 bhp, the Rinspeed Splash can reach 62 miles per hour from rest in under 6 seconds. Number 7. Sea Rotor Lamborghini Countach. The Lamborghini Countach is is the world's first amphibious Lamborghini, which automatically means it was not inexpensive at all. The Countach's front nose is lifted in the water, supported by a hydrofoil at the front. The mid-engine Countach was specifically developed by Sea Rotor Aquatech Mike Ryan to be amphibious. 8. Gibbs Aquadaw. The Gibbs Sports Amphibians in Auckland, New Zealand, developed the high-speed Aquadaw, capable of hitting 160 kilometers an hour on roads and 50 kilometers per hour in water. Aquadaw is designed to have the sports car style, handling, and performance, along with sports boat qualities by using a 2.5-liter Rover V6 engine and a jet drive. Whether it's land or water, the Aquadaw will not disappoint you. Built in 2003 and 2004, it is covered by over 60 patents in order to protect its propulsion systems. When it was being developed, it was built completely from scratch so as to ensure great performance. If sporty vehicles are your style and you're looking for your own amphibious vehicle, then the Gibbs Aquadaw is the car for you. 9. Amphicar 770. First sold in 1961, the Amphicar was designed by Hans Trippel. It was manufactured at Berlin Borsigwall. The Amphicar Corporation had received support from the German government in the marketing of the car in America. It was advertised as a sports car that could also act as a boat. For such a new item in the market, the Amphicar did impressively well. It sold about 3,800 units, most finding their way to the USA. The classic vintage-looking car was the first mass-produced amphibious vehicle. It used the 1.1-liter four-cylinder petrol engine from the Triumph Herald. Using a lever, the drive could be transferred to twin propellers. Amphicars had 43 horsepower and had a top speed of 7 knots in the water, steering using the front wheels as rudders. While they look super classy and retro, the metal body and salt water didn't go quite well together. For an amphibious vehicle, the car could rust very easily, which is why many Amphicar 770s crumbled away. However, it still remains a collectible automobile. 10. Watercar Python. Watercar combined a truck and a Corvette and developed the Python. It is powered by a Corvette-sourced LS series engine. It's got amazing performance both on land and in water. It can hit up to about 60 miles per hour in 4.5 seconds on land. It also remains fast in the water with a top speed of 60 miles per hour. Leaving its incredible performance aside, the Watercar Python is also one of the most cool-looking amphibious vehicles out there. Number 11. Chevrolet Corphibian. The Chevrolet Corphibian was based on a workhorse Chevy Corvair pickup truck. It was built to become an option for the Corvair truck, but was then transformed into a drivable boat. Absolutely incredible looking, only one of these was produced. It was recently sold at the Mecham auctions and still survives today. 12. Rinspeed Scuba. A one-off concept, the Rinspeed Scuba was directly inspired by the infamous 007 Lotus Esprit submarine from James Bond. It got a top speed of 75 miles per hour on land, and its propellers and twin blow jets propel it to only 2 miles per hour underwater. Although not for sale, the Rinspeed Scuba is a super cool amphibious vehicle. It takes the base of a Lotus Elise, installs an electric drivetrain, seals its electronic parts, and turns the car into a full-on submarine. It is the world's first submarine car. Passengers wear an oxygen regulator, just like they would if they go scuba diving, and dive underneath the water. When it was first unveiled in 2008, Rinspeed claimed that it had plans to make a production version. However, there has been no news about it yet. But anyway, we're happy knowing that something so cool exists. 13. Volkswagen Schwimmwagen. Primarily a German military vehicle during the Second World War, the Volkswagen Schwimmwagens were built in crazy numbers. Over 14,000 examples were made between 1942 to 1944. The Schwimmwagen used mechanicals from the VW Kubelwagen and Type 87 fitted inside a custom welded hull. It drove on all of its four wheels on land. In water, a screw propeller could be lowered. The Volkswagen Schwimmwagen only gave forward drive, so to reverse the car, Volkswagen provided an oar. 14. Dutton Surf. Veteran kit car manufacturer Tim Dutton's latest Dutton Surf is one of his most interesting productions. The Surf is based on the Suzuki Jimny. It is capable of 6 miles per hour in the water. 15. Sealander Schwimmer Caravan. Has the idea of a picnic in a car that also can be driven on water ever crossed your mind? How about partying in it with your friends? And how about just relaxing, having some of your precious me time in water alone in your car? All of it may sound crazy, but it is very much possible with the Sealander Schwimmer Caravan. Crafted by boat builders in Germany, it is the world's first and only amphibious caravan. Surprisingly, it can be towed by anyone with a normal car license due to its lightweight build. It's got room for 6 to sit and 2 to sleep. With that, we have come to the end of our list. All of these amphibious vehicles are amazing and built to perfection, or at least they were for their times. Which one is your favorite? favorite. Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to like and follow this podcast for more cool talks like this one.